We live in an age of mass extinction. Human interaction, disease, invasive species, and a greater competition for resources threaten the existence of our wildlife. In 2014, Conservation Biology Journal reported that species are being lost at a rate of 1,000 times faster than ever before in recorded history. Habitat destruction due to rapid urban development is one of the main drivers of this phenomenon. Without our help, they may not survive.
In 1973, under the Nixon administration, the federal government responded to this crisis by passing the Endangered Species Act to protect the biodiversity of our nation.
According to the Chapter 131A, Appendix 4 of the Endangered Species Act, the organism must be a native species that has lived within the state for the past 25 years. Endangered species include any wildlife in danger of extinction throughout all or a significant portion of its range, or in danger of extirpation from Massachusetts, as documented by biological research and inventory. Although all of these species are endangered, a select few are given greater importance, while others are ignored. But they all need our help. It is easy to understand why well-known species get a lot of attention and support from the government and the public.
But what about those less loved and even feared animals, like the timber rattlesnake? The timber rattlesnake has experienced a significant decline across its range and is continuing to disappear. Currently, there are less than 200 snakes left in Massachusetts. Intentional killing by humans, a deadly fungus, and natural predation are wiping out these snakes.
When the Pilgrims arrived, timber rattlesnakes were very widespread across all of New England.
The snake's restoration is a major concern and of high priority for Mass Wildlife. Mass Wildlife is accountable for the protection of all species, endangered or otherwise, and responsible for keeping the Endangered Species Act relevant in our minds. Currently, a plan exists to reintroduce a small population of these snakes onto Mount Zion, an unpopulated island in the Quabbin Reservoir, in collaboration with the Department of Conservation and Recreation.
It's our mission and it's our statutory responsibility to restore, conserve, and manage all of our wildlife resources in the state. And that means things that are very popular and things that aren't popular.
At the Roger Williams Zoo in Providence, Rhode Island, there are currently 6 young snakes being raised in captivity for future release on Mount Zion. We were able to get a first-hand look with expert Lou Parati to learn about why this program is so necessary.
You know, indiscriminate killing, poaching, rattlesnake numbers in a population could go down really, really fast because the recruitment isn't as fast as the loss.
Here on the island, the snakes will have the proper habitat they need for hibernation and breeding, but even this will take at least a decade to establish. Mount Zion is restricted from human access, keeping both snakes and humans safe, with full support from Quabbin Reservoir policy.
But our mandate at Quabbin is to preserve water for this and future generations, and also to protect the resources of the Commonwealth. And I consider this one of the resources. We do the eagles, we have loons, we have quite a number of rare and endangered plants that we keep an eye on and make sure they're doing all right. This fits right in with it in my thinking.
But some strong opposition still exists. Some people have pre-existing fears and a misconception of snakes. Others believe that they are a threat to their health and safety. Then there are residents who feel overlooked by government programs and want more involvement in the decision-making process.
I do think, like, one of the big things it seems to me that people are so worried about is that these snakes are going to spread, you know, that they're going to be around your sheep or your kids or your dogs or whatever.
But why does a rattlesnake even need to exist? Is it beneficial to mankind? Is it beneficial to the earth? Does it control the population of some other creature more dangerous than itself?
I wish you had taken a survey of in favor or not in favor?
Question. Should the people who drink the water from the Quabbin be concerned about the fact that a venomous reptile is swimming in their drinking water?
But how real are these risks, and what can we learn about these snakes to mindfully address these concerns?
We talked to herpetologists, conservationists, and wildlife professionals to get the facts about these mysterious creatures.
They're, you know, part of the ecosystem. They serve both as predators and prey for other animals. Red-tailed hawks and owls have been known to eat adult timber rattlesnakes, so they are just an integrated part of the ecosystem.
And all venomous snakes can control the amount of venom they use. They can hit you with all of it or none of it. A lot of bites in the United States from rattlesnakes are what they call dry bites. The snake will bite you but not inject any venom. Again, it doesn't want to waste it. One thing people don't usually realize is venom is not for protection in venomous snakes. Cobras have a hood for protection. Rattlesnakes have a rattle. Most of them are cryptically colored. So the rattlesnake's first line of defense is hope to God you don't see it because they blend in really well. If it feels as though it's been seen, it's going to rattle.
They can detect their prey. They have these exquisitely sensitive thermoreceptive pits on the side of their face. This is why they're called pit vipers. And these pits are sensitive to about 3/1000ths of a degree centigrade. And so when something that is mildly warmer than the background temperature, they can perceive that even in total darkness, and that way they can tell if there's a little mouse or a frog or something walking in front of them, and that helps them.
These fascinating reptiles can be perceived as dangerous, but are naturally shy and reclusive. Please support our state's policy of the protection and conservation of our endangered species. And most importantly, treasure all of our state's unique and natural beauty.